Welcome back to Let's Play Soul Blazer. When we last left off, we had just opened up the second of seven areas. This beautiful, lush forest. I do wonder, does every blade of grass count as its own separate soul here? And King Magrid didn't get any of them. His hit rate's going down and down and down the more we explore this world. But we must completely destroy this beautiful, pristine... Also, who cut down this tree? If there's nobody around with axes, how do we get this nice, clean stump? Anyway, we must build a civilization here. In Greenwood. Which means killing lots of mudmen. Which means kind of standing just off to the side of where they show up. Just above them. Just on the row above them. And they kind of walk right into the blade of my sword. Quite a lot of this in the game. As you've already seen. And the stump is slowly coming back to life now. Like we've restored the soul of that tree. And also of that bird. These lizards, oh, they shoot fireballs. But they don't actually... contains souls, I don't think. Yeah, there's not a monster. There's not a monster hole associated with those lizards. They're just everywhere. That was a good miss. That fireball went right through him. Oh, if he's at the edge of the screen, I guess he gets more iframes than is typical. Yeah, and if you don't kill the lizard on your first excursion into your blade, they actually get their hit points back when they jump back in the water. And they kind of jump out at you with no warning as well. Oh, wait a minute. No, they just have iframes when their vines are extending, is what it looks like. Well, okay. Get them the old-fashioned way. Why not? Ooh, glad we got that level up. We got that right when we needed it. Okay, so that opens the way into the first of three temples of Greenwood. Going up this way doesn't do anything yet, does it? We'll line up all the mudmen here and probably get a soul. Yeah, there we go. A dog! Everybody's favorite wild animal that lives in the forest. Basset hounds, to be precise. So Greenwood is split up into three temples out here in the marshlands that we're going to go through one at a time. And pretty much, we'll also make excursions back to town in between these little dungeons as... just kind of like we did in, Grass Valley. Just more with fire-breathing lizards this time. Than we'd otherwise be accustomed to. I kind of like this situation here. Their path just wanders right through my sword, and then their gem is... that falls out of their desiccated husk... happens to be right inside my hitbox. That's very friendly, actually. These guys, no such luck. Ugh, we don't want to be standing on this bridge, though. Evidently. Fair enough. I think we will get a better magic spell. See, we're hollowing out the trees. What do you mean you're starving? There's all these, like, flowers and nuts and berries and stuff out here. Come out and get you some, Hoss. You're not starving, you're lazy. Okay? That's what my stepmom would always just say. I'd be like, I'm hungry. She'd be like, you're not hungry, you're lazy. And you know what? She was right. I was lazy. I could have gone to the fridge. I could have made some mac and cheese. I was just being lazy. And so too is that squirrel. Can I please step on this, this button here? Thank you. Oh, we've gotta get rid of this waterfall next. Can I stand, like, pretty much here-ish and be... Looks like these guys are a little more aggressive by spitting out their vines. Ooh, whoops. It is interesting to see how the same monsters in different monster layers will behave somewhat differently. Yeah, these guys are a little more aggressive. They want to throw out their vines a little earlier. So as long as I stay up here, they won't get me. Another Boyd. This place is lousy with birds. I'm sorry, Boyd. Exaboid, in fact. Yeah, I don't think the lizards have a monster lair. If we get to the end and there's one monster lair remaining, I think we'll know what to do, but... Can I go up and around this way? I feel like I can get behind these... Ow. Ow! Nice. Beautiful. Yeah, we can get right behind here. And inside is... 150 gems. So I don't even know how many casts that turns into. I don't know how many gems each fireball is actually using. Oh, you're gonna get stuck right there, huh? That suits me fine. Provided we don't die constantly, which is certainly a possibility. We might end this game with a ludicrous amount of gems. Ooh, I got some exp. Nah, I'm good. I'm gonna stay here. So you kind of have the main overworld swamp area of Greenwood, and then you've got the three temples, and I think each temple has three floors, is kind of how it breaks down. There's water, there's fire, and there's light. And here's a mole. A mole hole. It's a creature who brings light to darkness. So, not a mole, then. Because a mole does not do that, I'm pretty sure. He got a spare medical herb. One monster lair remaining, so... Oh, there it is. Did we miss it, or can we not reach it yet? Looks like we have to come down those stairs. Alright, fair enough. So we just can't reach it yet. I was being so careful to not get baited by that lizard, and yet... And yet... Operation Be More Careful is now in effect. Well, maybe it's not, if we're being honest. Oh, there was my medical herb, so it's a good thing I picked that up, I guess. Operation Be More Careful is not in effect. I'm wearing my armor, right? Yeah, I'm wearing whatever armor I can get my hands on. Delicious seeds. I wonder what we're gonna do with those. I guess it depends on how delicious they are, because I might want those for myself. Once in a while, not often, but once in a while, I get a craving for sunflower seeds. And get myself a big bag. And, like, by the time I'm halfway through the bag, I'm, like, absolutely sick of sunflower seeds. Like, why would I want a whole bag of these? It's ridiculous. Quite a lot of these guys in here. I think we're gonna stand back and do this the safe way. I don't actually buy my sunflower seeds from Safeway. I don't know if we got Safeway stores in the area. Are you also the creature that brings light to the darkness? A crocodile! And by crocodile, they mean bridge. I love how they purpose some of the souls just to kind of open up the world outside of the dungeons. It's kind of an interesting way to do things. Not every soul is an NPC that you talk to and run a fetch quest for. Okay, that's it for them. found a strange bottle just laying on the floor. Very strange indeed. Three more monster layers on this floor. One of these statues is slightly discolored. Where'd it go? There it is. Haha! I don't remember what happens when you... if you just, like, walk past that statue. I think it just wakes up and fires at you if you don't actually try to kill it first. We probably have two more of those guys on this floor somewhere. Yeah, here we go, in this room here. Like, you? Ah, I knew you were in here. And you here. Wah! I'll take that hit. Oh, he's got one hit point left. Sniped him with a fireball. There's like a weird mole romance story that we're going to uncover as part of Greenwood. And one more layer in the water shrine. What is this, the third floor down? Hi, guys. Sorry, not sorry. And that should do it for the third floor. Then we'll come up to the second floor, where we should have one more layer, and then up to the top floor, which will give us egress back out into the swamp. Just kind of an A to B dungeon here. Yeah, no layers left here. One layer left here. There it is. And we have released a deer. On a stage, so we've already destroyed part of the forest to build this garish, ghastly stage. And we've got one more Mudman layer here. Very slow Mudmen pouring out of here. These Mudmen ain't got no hustle right here. Ain't got no hustle. Now, take your time, boys. Take your time. We got all day. We're fine. They got no hustle, but they got all kinds of iframes coming out. Alright. So, whoop. Hi. What the... ah. That was a cheap trick. A cheap trick indeed. I'm gonna go ahead and walk into that fireball, if that's okay. And, yeah, we should be done with the water shrine now. But, unfortunately... oh, never mind. I thought we were coming out of the fire shrine. There's a pretty hilarious roadblock. I mean, you'll see it. You'll see it. We'll get there. These games do tend to have roadblocks from time to time, and this might be the funniest one in the game. Maybe of its era of video gaming. Keeping in mind this predates Golden Sun, and oh, you can't go that way because there are puppies playing. Which is actually a thing that Golden Sun does. He just blocks off a path because there's puppies playing in the way. Ah, very nice. There's our way back, once we're ready to go back, which we're not quite just yet. I would like to go ahead and... no point going back if we don't have all the monster layers from the area that we can reach. Yeah, go ahead. Vine me up, Daddy. I'm happy getting vined here because I'm about to go into God's house anyway and get all my health back. Watch me die before that happens. That'd be funny. Okay, so the fire shrine is now open, but we can't really... we could go in there and do a little bit of damage, but... better to head back to Greenwood now and check out all of the beautiful, beautiful souls that we've so far rescued. So, we've got the stage here. Actually, the first thing we need to check out is there is a treasure box back there that we cannot reach. We can start going into these trees. Hello, Mr. Squirrel. Turbo the dog. That's who we're looking for here. Shoutouts to Nourishim for sponsoring this video. If you liked the video and you want to see more, please tickle my thumb, leave a friendly comment, and ring my little bell.